close quarters, couldn't stuff it home. Rebound, drive, title, somehow that stayed out. Senators wild scramble, shooting and scoring. Ryan Nugent Hopkins, 6-3 Edmonton. And Forsberg may be hurt.
I think so too. He has not moved since he went down in that position. He had to really extend to make that save on Dreisaitl. And Hyman also had some contact with him as he was down, but it looked to me like Hyman might have been pushed in that scrum. But he's in some distress, no question about that. He did not move once he was in that position. That goal mouse scramble before Nugent Hopkins eventually fished that puck out and was able to elevate over top and put it in the net. And Matt Sogard right now is warming up because he saw kind of what happened, and I don't think he thinks he's going to get back in there. And situation like this, 6-3, if this goal does count, which it looks like it's going to. I don't think there's any goaltender interference because the player was pushed into the goaltender. And I think Ottawa figures that too, as they Zub is out of the box and heading over to the bench. But the concern now is Forsberg still down on the ice and has not moved from that position. Here it is here. Hyman drives this. There's contact there. That little bump there by Hammond, it kind of bumps into Forsberg, but I don't where he suffered the injury on this play. Yeah, Hyman does come down on that right pad and folds the leg back a little bit.
And they're bringing the stretcher.
Yeah, the way he was in that position. So he's trying to resist against it, and then you're going to see Hyman is pushed. Now he's in that blue paint. He is pushed into Forsberg, but he does go down. He puts the weight down on the right leg.
Cam Talbot out with a groin injury. That's why he's unavailable to the Senators tonight. And
devastating for the Senators.
Forsberg, who was so good last year, 22 wins and a .917 save percentage for a club that was 9 games under .500. And he's shaken up here, and even Hyman recognizes the gravity of this situation. Here's a call.
Determine if there was goaltender interference prior to the goal.
They're going to review this. If it counts, it's Nugent Hopkins' 24th of the season, likely from McDavid and Dreisaitl on the power play. And unfortunately, for really everyone involved, Forsberg down and out. And Mads Sogard will be coming into this game when we come back. Edmonton 6, Ottawa 3. For now, the goal under review.
Ottawa has challenged the previous play.
And Ottawa Senators has made the official challenge. It's brought to you by our pals at Specsavers. And that is just one of the storylines surrounding this potential power play goal for Ryan Nugent Hopkins. But you can see Anton Forsberg unable to get up after a collision in front and some full body weight landing on Anton Forsberg. And we certainly hope that isn't the type of injury that ends his season, but as you can tell, he's in significant pain, and unfortunately does not look great.
You knew right away he didn't move. And anytime a goaltender, they just have that understanding of what's going on with their bodies, probably more than most players, because they're so flexible, they move around, they have to put themselves into different positions that not too many people can even get into. And he just knew right away something was wrong, and he didn't move, waited for the medical staff to get on the ice, and he did not move from that position until they put him on that stretcher. And you're hoping that he's okay, and it was not as bad as it looked, because it didn't look good the way Hyman came down on that pad. There was nowhere for his leg to go, and it just kind of bent back underneath him.
So now Mads Sogard into the game, 6'7". Zach Hyman, you could tell he was visibly shaken, because you never want to, you know, be in the vicinity of a guy where, you know, inadvertent or not, you land on him and put him in a prone position. But Mads Sogard, who's 1-1 for his NHL career, .889 save percentage.
It was deemed a contact by number 23 of Ottawa, causes the old situation. Therefore, it is a good goal.
There it is. So the contact on Hyman led to him falling on Forsberg.
And here's the thing. It wasn't a ton of contact by Hamonic, but just that push for Hyman, he's got nowhere to go, and he almost toe picks on the goaltender, and his knee goes down on top of the pad. Here it is again. He drives in. It's not that bump. It's this push right here. There's nowhere for him to go. He trips over the pad, and that's what hurts Forsberg. And you can see the look on Zach Hyman's face on the bench, too. He was not too happy with this. You don't want to hurt a goaltender. He's in there digging away, just trying to be a thorn in the side and score a goal on the power play. And in the process, takes out the goaltender with just a fluky injury, really, with the position that pad was in.
So Sogard, who's been banged up this year in the American Hockey League, 6-9-2 for Belleville. We'll get the call in net.